Well, Sugats came to me one day and said, you know, it'd be a great idea doing a 30 for 30 on Antonio Cromartie. A great idea that he stole from Twitter, but a good idea nonetheless. But we had difficulty navigating how we'd produce this without making it seem like we were making fun of the dude. So I feel like really just praising him and going against all odds is the way to go.
All right. And so how do you feel about it? How do you guys feel about the bit?
We'll see. We'll put it together.
I gotta be honest, the first time I've been nervous about what
it is. Okay, let's see.
What if I told you that Antonio Cromartie may have retired, but his Wang is still playing at an all-pro level? That science was no match for the nads of a champion. That over an 11-year career, not only did he average 2.8 interceptions, but also 1.2 children per season. That it simply couldn't be contained once it left the pocket. That his swimmers would have probably beat that Phelps shark. That Green Bay's not the only ones packing. That there isn't anyone who could escape this sack. That the deepest threat he ever faced is attached to him. That playing opposite of Darrell Revis is nothing compared to the challenge of putting 14 children through college. That the expression, if you don't use it, you lose it, isn't real. But even if it was, in this case, losing it might not be the worst thing. That it might be time to follow up with his urologist. That perhaps having one after a vasectomy should have been a bigger red flag that it didn't take.
How long is this?
That if you chopped it off, I'm almost certain another would immediately grow back in its place. That for now, he has the lead, but Philip Rivers is only down 6, and he's marching his way downfield. ESPN Film presents a 30 for 30, the incredible underdog story of a penis that survived what was supposed to be the final cut. It's long.
It was very long.
I've watched that, though. I've watched that 30.
The bit. The radio bit.